Can we get one bit quiet? Tennis, he rang. I said Pentecost Sunday, and what a mighty God we serve. If he's a mighty God, somebody just jump up and shout, mighty God. I said, if you know he's a mighty God, if you have any movement in your body, jump up and shout, mighty God. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. The angels bow before him. He can have my seat. Elder Mixon, he can have my seat. The angels bow before him, talking about the Father, not the Son. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Now, I have a lot to announce, so let me get it out the way. I didn't stop you from dancing, shouting, running, leaping. But this guest artist that came to our church and tried to bring the fire all the way down. Oh, come on, Shabbat. Y'all know we don't play that. You can have my favor without being my favorite. Favorite never transfers to favor. But this young man is fully, totally anointed of God. His group, they shared with us. I think that we should honor the gift in the Reverend Dr. Dexter Alexander. Stan Derek Alexander, can we clap, scream, and holler for the gift? And DDA Music Group, I don't believe in clapping for one and leaving out the other, so the other three, stand, will you? So we can love on you also. Very, very anointed, not just talented. Y'all are not greasy, y'all are oily. A lot of folk are greasy, but that man of God is oily. I don't do a lot of prophesying on this side of the town. I do it in my preaching, just left preaching. Did we have a good time over at Macedonia? I didn't let my musicians loose because we'd have still been there. We'd have still been at Macedonia. I saw them getting ready. They were going in for the kill. Save that for our house. I want to thank all of you who traveled with me over there to support your pastor. I am so grateful for you. Can you clap for the members? I'm so grateful. For you that didn't know, I preached in 32 minutes. full throttle. I don't cut no corners. I put the mic down 3 times. And they made me pick it back up 3 times. Someone, a big renowned preacher, had a bet on it and he lost. Shame on him. But we had a great time over there. And I pastored this time. Today, y'all made me proud. I pastor a great church. And I appreciate y'all for supporting your pastor. And y'all were loud. Not Deacon Mays, but the rest of y'all. Y'all were loud. Y'all had Baptist and AME people looking left and right. But you gotta get in where you fit in, amen? Did not Dr. Mixon preach this morning? Did not Associate Pastor Jay preach this morning? And I mean, I ain't talking about no play stuff. That was some preaching. And I think I'm praying about it, so this is in the air, but I need 50 folk to jump and catch it. I think on June the 30th, we're going to repeat that because that's just a beautiful situation to look at. We are an equal opportunity ministry. But we gotta find who you match with. And those two, good God. They preach me happy. We are blessed, and I'm sorry that I have to do this, but I need to acknowledge our visitors tonight. Can you clap better than that? I need to acknowledge. I will not be acknowledging any birthdays. This is Pentecost. It's the church birthday. If you have a GoFundMe, just put it out there. But I want to acknowledge. Now, I was about to prophesy, and I pulled back.
Well, prophesy, sir.
No. Y'all not draining me. I'm going home. But I pulled back. Now that I'm older, I know how to do this. Some people get a prophecy, and when it don't come to pass, they call you a false prophet when they're a false recipient. Prophecy demands that you take on a responsibility for the word that you get. So I don't want a lot of that going on in my church because we're a word church. And the Bible cannot fail. Can I get a witness? But I wanted to say to you, Brother Alexander, stand up. I want to say something to you. When I was up here standing, I inquired of you from two people. They really only know of you. They don't know you. So this is not secondhand because I didn't pay them no attention. They just knew of your fame. That's it. But the Lord knows your heart. And the Lord tells me, he says, speak to him. And based upon him running or screaming or someone that loves him doing it, God says, I'm going to rewind the past 3.5 years. God says, I'm about to throw him in the devil's face. I'm about to put him all the way there. Aye, y'all playing up here or y'all want to sit down there? I saw a building being built around you. The Lord says, this is not a restart, this is a reset. God says, you don't have to keep changing names. God says, I'm gonna change what I wanna change. God says, let them call you what they wanna call you. I'm gonna change your season, not your name. Jabez didn't get a name change. He just said, Lord, enlarge my territory. God said, be very still for the next 30 to 60 days Consecrate yourself not in fasting, but in prayer and in being to yourself more than ever. God says, after those days, you will never be alone again. You will never be looked or frowned upon again. God said, by the month of the end of July, you will be blessed everywhere you turn your head. And someone with a loud mouth, clap your hands and rejoice. When one rejoice, this is a prophetic church, but we are not prophetic junkies. The word of God, the written word, the logos keeps us very balanced in this place called Tabernacle. But that's his prophecy. It's going to happen quick, fast, and in a hurry. Tap a neighbor that looks friendly and tell them quick, fast, and in a hurry. Talk to the neighbor. Tell him whatever you need God to do, he's going to do it quick, fast, and in a hurry. No more slow motion. I don't hear nobody. No more slow motion. God is going to do it quick, fast, and in a hurry. Let me acknowledge guests and prophesy in the midst of acknowledging guests. Bible said that when the Holy Ghost falls, your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Old men shall dream dreams. Young men should have vision. If you're sitting next to the right person or close enough, see if they're right by telling them tomorrow is the beginning of your new season. Speak that. Oh, tomorrow. Tomorrow. Where's my oil? Bring my oil up. Don't drop that. Bring a table. Follow your common sense. A table. Anyone that is to my left, anyone that's sitting close and you're judging and you don't like the noise, I'm going to ask you to change your seat and get out that front row. With that foul, self-righteous spirit. I want y'all to buy it. I have no problem calling you out or pointing at you. But if you're going to be up front, be up there with some power. Oh, whatever you need God to do, he's going to do it. What? Your bills might be paid by tomorrow morning. Let me acknowledge our guests while I'm prophesying. I feel old school, and I know a lot of you are not agile and fluid enough to just keep standing and sitting because we're living in a lazy generation day. But some of you that can jump up with joy, just jump up and act like you got preacher on you and say, it's already done. Say it like you got the Holy Ghost. It's already done. It's already. Already. Already done. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. Otona manciayo. Oshanamai. It's the Patashanda the boat. It's Pentecost, baby. Oh. La Cora Mancianda. I still hear quick, fast, and then a hurry. The Winans, be seated. One of the most famous gospel groups ever said, they said, ain't no need to worry what the night is going to bring. God told me to tell you. Come on, encourage your neighbor. It's going to be all over. In the morning. The scripture, behave yourself in that front row. Say, weeping may endure for a night. Somebody that's loud, jump up and say, but joy come in. Joy, joy, joy. Joy, joy, joy. Joy. We're blessed to have guests from Newport Richey, Florida. I want to get through all of this. Newport Richey, be careful, goddaughter. Newport Richey, Florida. Two apostles are with us, and we're blessed to have them. Apostle George McKay III, where are you? Can we clap for Apostle George McKay III? And Apostle and Dr. Rebecca McKay, please stand. Let's salute them with all honor and deference. Thank you for being here with us on Pentecost Holiday, Florida and St. Petersburg. They are guests of these two individuals. See, guests keep bringing guests. I got to hold a meeting with my church. Their guests that are here with us is Angelique Harris. Angelique Harris, where are you? Please stand, remain standing. Terrell Rembert, where are you? Please remain standing. Minister Marilyn Rembert, let's clap for them and Shabbat God for their attendance. I want to go ahead and be seated. I want to say to this section, y'all a little quiet tonight, but I understand. But within this section, there are two peoples whose tumors are dissolving. And one of them is near the Rembert clan. Shamandia. Now I'm trying to help you all. I'm trying to help her. I'm trying to help her. It'll be dissolved about time you walk out this building. I'm trying to help you. And you'll remember it because it happened on Pentecost. I command that take place quick. You may be seated. From Jarrell, Texas, we got people from everywhere. They watch us by YouTube. So did the McKay family. Don't worry, we ain't gonna put the fire out. Tawana Perlow, where are you? Tawana Perlow, can y'all clap for Sister Tawana in your section? Along with Janiya Wilson, Janiya, and Job Thomas. Can we clap for these from Jarrell, Texas? I want to say to Job, stand. How old are you? 23. If I told you something that God gave me, would you try to believe it? All right. Based on your activity, because on Pentecost, Nothing stands still. So based on your activity, when you stood up, the Lord said, tell him, I got two things. Tell him he has options. I can either fund him going back to school or I give him the job that he's been waiting on. The Lord said, based on your praise, whichever one you say, that's the one you're going to get. And somebody ought to help this brother. Everybody don't praise the same, but don't judge me. This person visited our Wednesday Bible study night, decided to come back tonight. Minister Zoe Fuller, where are you? Zoe, can y'all clap for Zoe Fuller and love her in that section? Zoe, you married? Where is he? I want you to text him, and this is what you're going to tell him. You're going to say, I went to church anyway, and I'm glad I went, in your own words. You're going to tell him God is going to fully give you the Holy Ghost, and you and I are moving into a new house. Y'all ain't y'all. And somebody with a loud mouth better send up that praise. Thank you, Jesus. I'm sorry, I'm acknowledging our guests, but at the same time, I'm blessing a few of them. Nobody has to come to your house. No one has to travel and come into your sanctuary. And I'm sorry if any of my members ain't got the right attitude and some of them are nasty, but that ain't from their pastor. That's from their mama. With loving kindness. Now I'm laughing because the Lord said, being that Zoe believed what I said anyone within five rows on each side, your new house is coming also. Anyone between five rows. Y'all jealous or y'all can't scream for them? Is there a problem here? Be seated. This person's husband, ain't gonna prophesy to everybody, but this person's husband came on Wednesday night and Apostle McKay told them about the Shabbat Church. This is all I see. They are also from Newport St. Richie. Minister Nicole Robinson, where are you? Can you clap for Nicole Robinson? I don't know what I'm saying. But the Lord said, at the birth of the child, are you with child? At the birth of this child that's going to be a prophet, at the birth of this child, you shall get your family back regardless of what they think about the family you're in. And God said, tell you, I'm boosting his credit up to 790 so that y'all can, are y'all jealous or y'all okay? I don't care if my church don't know what they have. You're going to learn after a while. I appreciate God making me a vessel willing to speak into people's lives without any bias. Without any discrimination. I will prophesy good things to my enemies. I'm too mature to let you get under my skin. Pastor Tamika Robinson is one of our own from Jacksonville. She invited two guests with her, three, Ebony and Cedric Partey. Where are you? Where are you? Make yourself known. They're way in the back. Y'all scream for them. And Jante Wilson. We want to thank God for all. Jante, how old are you? I want to say something to you. It's going to sound like I'm a false prophet. I know when I'm leaning, you know, and God says some people are questioning you. So your generation is known for too much guessing. But let me help you. If I can get you to run, two things are going to happen. Number one, God says he doesn't care what happened to you in junior high school. See, I know I'm in it. I don't even care about my church. High school. The devil said he'll be a failure and never make it. But God said if he prays me, there's a driver's license over his head. Because you're about to be blessed like never before. And somebody ought to help them praise God from Jacksonville. Facebook has been kind to our ministry. We have guests from Daytona Beach, Florida. And I want this person to stand and we're going to bless everybody. We're almost through. Tia Culver, where are you, Tia? Tia's in the red. Can we thank God for Sister Tia? How long have you lived in Daytona? All your life, you do know that your wealth is not where you live. And you've been asking God, Lord, I don't know how I'm going to do it. The finances, I need to know because I'm just not going to get up, pick up and go. When will you be 30? Are you 29? In October coming, you'll be 30? On your birthday, God will unwrap all your gifts, your guidance, your direction. And somebody from our church and from the kingdom. Another person is from Daytona. It's Anissa Wilson, Anika Wilson. Can y'all thank God for her? How do we pronounce your name? Anissa, all right, because I am a stickler for names. Can I ask you a personal question and you don't have to answer it? Have you ever been married before? Are you prepared if he should propose now? You sure? Bring this back down. Who in here playing? Are you sure? I want to tell you, and don't take me wrong, don't try to make it work. Something for your from your past just got delivered. You have an idea of who I'm talking about. God says he's coming back clean with a job, ready to do what he promised. And anyone not jealous ought to jump up, clap, and shabak God. Oh, somebody's asking, is he prophesying from paper? I wish I knew how to cheat. I pray to God I'm not like the others, but I wish. Oh, how I wish some raindrops would fall. Give me some of my volume back and then freeze yourself. Genesis, thank you, Worship Center, Tampa, Florida. Clap for that ministry. I said clap for that ministry. Because we're all one body. I'm not going to let my church become a part of none of the foolishness that's going on around the world. Amen. Sister, I call her Three Ward. Where you at? Three went and brought a guest with her. Her name is Chantier Mansfield. Where are you, Chantier? Can y'all clap for Chantier? Am I saying your name right? All right. You can be seated. Look at that. A friend told this person about our church. They live here in Orlando. Hopefully they'll love it tonight. Faith Salters. Where's Faith Salters? Can y'all clap for Sister Faith? That's not a good enough applause. A friend told her, that's good. That's good. Sister Mansfield, stand up a minute. Who does your hair? Now, notice what I just did. You took the prophecy away from me because now you blew it, but I'm still going to do it. See, I was playing to get you there where you need to be, but I wanted to tell you this. I'm not insulted because it makes my job easy. But the Lord said, ask her who does her hair. Some of you are prophetic, but you don't know about the prophetic. Because you'd be like, if God's talking, then why you ask questions, Bishop? The same reason why God asked Adam, where art thou? What, he didn't know? He could have told the tree, fall down. God is about relationships. And some of you don't have any because you don't effectively communicate. So you have the person, you just don't have a relationship. The Lord told me to tell you that he's been working on you over 12 years. God says, I've seen her come and go, come and go, come and go. And I'm telling her that tonight, gracefully, is her last night to give me her all. Because the Lord says, I'm going to give her two salons. Two. One is going to be open in the future almost 24 hours a day. Y'all ain't talking. And somebody that's not jealous, we are not jealous. I hear somebody, it don't make sense to have no hair salon 24 hours. Not yours. But if McDonald's can stay open, if Wawa's can stay open, if Walmart can be open, if the liquor store, all right, let me get out of here. It don't mean she has to work all 24 hours. She can hire and empower other people. If anyone in here feels like you have businesses on the inside, jump up and say, birth it, Lord, birth it. Birth it. Birth it. I'm almost done. Charleston, South Carolina, one of my favorite preach cities. Charleston, South. Shaunice Butler, stand. Y'all heard her this morning. She's over in the corner. She's invited some guests along with their children. Shantae Dove, along with Lucille Marie and children. Now, I don't know how this works. It says Shantae Dove, Lucille Marie and children. Where are you all? Can we clap for that whole section right there? That's not good enough. I don't know which one of you, but one of you are running. You are prophetic. One of you is running, and you are fully prophetic. Now, if you don't put your hand up, I'm going to point out to which one it is, then it won't go well. But one of you are running. Thank you. Listen, I have no problem. This is my church. You are prophetic. Everything in your life is moving, but it's not producing. God says, you should be extremely wealthy by now. God says, my hand's been on her since she was 2 years old. Tell her tonight, if she say yes, Lord, I will give it to her quick. Are y'all with fast? Y'all gonna help sister right there? Now, I have thusly already prophesied to over 12 people. Some of you can't get one right. But you always have an opinion about someone. Just because you don't like them mean God ain't gonna bless them. You better love to start liking whoever God is speaking well of. I'm telling you. Be on God's side, not the side of your emotions. Blacks Memorial Church of God in Christ, Pompano Beach, Florida. Clap for that ministry. No, clap for that ministry. I'm Kojic and I've never heard of this church. Blacks Memorial Church of God in Christ, Pompano Beach, Florida. I'm looking forward to meeting them. They are guest of three people. Three people who are not members invited, one guest from Blacks Memorial. Yes, April Moore, Richard Dees, and Betty Moore. Please stand. They're not members. They're visiting. Can y'all clap for them? And they invited Sister Katrina Fuller. Where's Katrina? Can we clap and give God praise for them? All right. I'm done being a secretary. I want you to look at your neighbor, say these two words, then I want to thank God for two more people, then I'm going straight into the Bible. But I want you to say these two words to make sure that you are strategically postured near someone who's not jealous of your future. All I want you to do is look him in the eye without fear and tell him you're next. Just go and tell him. All right, be seated. You that are looking around at folk that are screaming like they're retarded, it may not be them. Do we look at you retarded when you in the club twerking and dropping? Do we look at you when you're inebriated and can barely walk? Do we look at you like that? This is the behavior of Pentecost. The Bible said we are not drunk as ye suppose. It didn't say we're not drunk. For this is new wine. Y'all ain't talking to me. And anybody that knows that you're fearless and you don't care who laugh at you, jump up, shake yourself, scream glory, turn around. This is the posture of Pentecost. Be seated. This is the posture of Pentecost. Now, I said I had three more, then we're going to the Bible. And I'm going to do somewhat similar to what I did at Macedonia. Especially for you that want to go home. I'm going to let you go. You ain't going home to nothing, but I'm going to let you go, though. But we do have a sister church called Vertical in Tampa. I don't hear nobody, Florida, whose leader and pastor and prophet is Pastor J. Anthony Brown. And I think we should salute him with all the honor that's due to him. He's been with his bishop all day. He asked me, where you get all that strength from? My own son asked me, I don't know how you did this today. I said, it's called a passion for Christ. And if anybody ever gets a true passion for Christ, he'll give you strength that you never had in your life. To his left is a wonderful young man. He has visited this church several times, at least three or four. He is one of God's great preachers. He is also an author of two books. You have to get it. It will help anyone who is experiencing or in the midst of a divorce. His book is powerful. Bishop Johnny Sanders, stand so we can give you the respect and honor. Can y'all do that right now? Now, this one, I'm going to need everyone to stand if you're able. To the left is a man who knew me since I was a little boy. I was a little lad. He used to preach in New York, moved to Columbus, Ohio, started a church. All his sons, or most of them, are preachers and bishops. He has blessed multiple tens of thousands around the world. He just so happens not to be my father. He should have. He's Johnny's father. But he should have been mine. He'd have been a little more proud if it was me. But I want to appreciate this sagacious man of God who is a true definition of an apostle. Apostle Sanders, we salute you here at the Shabbat Church for your service. I don't hear nobody to the kingdom of God. Thank you. I won't tell you his age, but he looked younger than most of y'all. I won't tell you his age, but that man is holding his youth better than all of us and still matching his colors. Go on and be clean. I don't know who this person is at all, but while I'm standing here for the past 8 minutes, the Lord says, I want you, and you will notice I got a little cup here, and it's full of anointing oil, not for y'all, but whoever the Lord tell me to touch, right? Got some cloths here. I don't know what's going to happen. But the Lord told me, you must anoint this one lady because in the future, she will be picking up where you leave off. I'm not dying. He said he's going to make her now go into a season that's not going to make sense. Her season is going to catapult her to heights unknown. She has no idea that it's her. I don't even know her name. When I point to her, if she allows me to anoint her head, God says, within the next coming months, I'm going to situate her to become a new example to the women across the world. You're wearing white. Your hair is in the bun. Come to me. Do we know each other? We don't. You have visited here? All right. I want to anoint you, and I want to tell you to get ready for the greatest transition of your life. God says, I want to bless her for the past 9 years. When I anoint her head, any of you that know what Holy Ghost praise sounds like, give it up. Now, God, we thank you for her. Do it in the name of Jesus Christ. I don't hear no praise up in this sanctuary. Hallelujah. To the woman standing, can I anoint your head? Please come. Now, people that know me know I don't touch a lot of people, even when I travel. Not my thing. I want to say something to you, but I'm going to say it in your ear. When I anoint a head, I want my church, even if the visitors are rude and won't praise for other people, because I think I've already prophesied myself tired. You don't know what that takes out of a vessel. And you don't know how many spirits attack that vessel. But can you come closer? When I touch her, all of you that will make noise unto God, do it now in Jesus' name. Watch out now, son. Move on. Don't stay too close. Glory to God. Some of you don't understand what's going on, but it's okay. This is not a regular service. This is Pentecost. Hiya! Be seated. And let me do this Sunday school lesson. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Hosanna Mahai. To my Caucasian black member holding the baby that just stood up. Give the baby to somebody and come to me. See, white people are more humble than black. I need you to look at me and I need to ask you a question. May not make sense. Because God says, tell her I'm giving her a new heart. Because this one has been abused. This one has been torn. Someone in particular tried to rip that heart out your chest. A situation, Shandaba, you can't catch from way back there. Who died? Something is going on. You have to let this go. Hashemaho!
Hallelujah.
When I lay hands on you, your heart will change in 48 hours. Your strength will come back. God says, tell her wherever she desires to move, tell her, tell me. Because God says, I'm going to open a miracle door for her concerning that. When I lay hands on her, I want to hear the loudest praise. Do it now. Hug her, Chantel. People need love. Hey, you fix this at home and learn how to talk and make sense because you're smart. Just for a little season, one of your children is going to have to go to a different school because they're becoming a genius. The one that will look like they're falling behind in class is about to excel like never before. Y'all think God don't care about children? Be seated. Stop looking at them. Them pants ain't dirty. That's the style. They're dirty in front and back. They're called dirty jeans. Be seated. The rest of the night should be easy, smooth sailing. Get your Bibles. Turn with me to the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. I want 30 of you to get selfish and just pause, jump up and say, I'm next. Just go and get, just go and be a little selfish. Bishop Johnny, if at any time in my hoop you want some, you can come share with me. It's Pentecost. I'm not giving it to your daddy, though, because we won't get it back. Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4 is a familiar passage, but I want to read it anyhow, and then we're going to go to the book of Judges, chapter 15. Right after Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4, we're going to go to Judges. While I am doing this, get Father Hope up, who the power of God is on. Have him walk with him with the bowl, right? And let him anoint the first five rows people's heads without prophesying and screaming. Get that job done while I'm reading. I said, let him walk down the steps. Stop being young and go walk down the steps. First five rows. Don't miss one person. I can't let some of you touch people because you ain't clean for real. So you're not doing this job. Go back, first five rows on one side. Don't overwork them. First five rows on that side. Samuel did not anoint all of the sons of Jesse. It don't mean you're not chosen because you ain't got some oil. Some of you were anointed before you got here. Stand on that. No talking as he's laying hands. Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. What did I say over there? And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one place. They were all with one accord in one place. Five rows of people. Did he get all of them? Five rows on one side. That side. Five rows of that one side. Amen. You're done with your job. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. It filled all the house where they were sitting. Every person that he put his hands on, God said, in 8 days, I'm changing your direction. Every last one of you. They were all, suddenly there came a sound, be seated from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house. I know y'all thinking I'm going to preach the same sermon from over there. No. Where they were sitting, there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire. Dr. Sharon, and it sat upon each of them. Look at somebody and tell them something good is happening over your head. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. I wish I had some old saints that knew how to say Holy Ghost. Began to speak with not new tongues, other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. If you can't control your tongues, you don't have the Holy Ghost. Along with the volume comes utterance. So stop doing it to get attention. That's the Pentecostal experience, is Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. That's the Pentecostal experience. The only thing I want you to focus on in that particular passage for three folk who push their pastor is the word fire. Somebody shout fire. There appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and that fire sat upon each of them. You know, because y'all not talking because you now want prophecy, that's why I don't do it. Ain't gonna be no junkies up in here. But let me tell you something. Let me make a common logical statement for 10 folk who will scream loud. If you're on fire, you can't burn someone that's already on fire. Some of you are making folk upset because they have no fire. Why you keep screaming in my ear, baby, I'm on fire. And I ain't never seen nobody on fire not scream. One of the X-Men characters, I know I'm gonna read Judges right after this, but one of the, is that a Marvel comic? I don't know. Is it a DC comic? Marvel, thank you, because that's what God wants your enemies to do, marvel at you. Look, somebody tell him, I'm gonna be so blessed, you're gonna marvel at me. Tell him, if you hate me now, you're going to want to kill me later, because what you thought I have, I'm about to really have. See, the Lord will produce jealousy. Jealousy is the way that your enemy prophesies. Because if they're jealous, that meant they see what God's about to give you, even though you're worrying why they're so jealous about me. Because they have a spirit that is showing them your future. Sometimes you don't need a prophet, you just need someone jealous. If you got five folk jealous of you at one time, you closer than you think. Stop giving jealousy all your energy and just tell them, thank you for knowing who I am. Now, Lord, everyone that pushes me for the next 15 minutes, be kind to them. Be extremely kind to them, as you have made me the shepherd of this flock. But they had one man who was made out of brick. Walked around being strong. He was called Thing. Then you had a woman who could basically make herself and her emotions disappear. Like some of you in here tonight. You ain't gonna show how you really feel because it might hurt you too much. Then there are men in here trying to be harder than they have to be. And you'll find out later, when a man has to always do that and be hard on everybody, he's no thing. Then you had one who was a professor, and his issue was, and I want his issues, he could stretch. It's called the Fantastic Four, baby. Stay with me. He could stretch. Touch somebody and tell them, my money been stretching, everything been stretching. Tell them, I'm stretched out. But then you had this young millennial who had to learn how to control his gift. His gift was, he would say, flame on. Snap his finger, and he would catch on fire. I'm sorry y'all don't like what I'm preaching. At the end of the story, they had a villain that was stronger than all of them, who also took away some of their power and authority. See, some of you, he preaching about comics. You don't want Greek and Hebrew. You're not that intelligent, are you? I'm trying to preach to you like Jesus did, in parables. You don't know nothing about Hamateo and Xenoglossalia and Glossalia. You know nothing about, there's a pericope passage of scripture pregnant with the possibilities of preaching, and in the attunement of print we find the words of young Apostle Paul. You really don't know that. You just like it. But I need something I can use. Tell somebody, I need something I can use. He got rebuked all the time, like most young people, because he was just out there sporting his gift. He didn't take his gift serious. Do I have talkers? And when the villain was about to destroy the planet and the world, Mr. Professor who can stretch, Mr. Brickhouse who was a thing, and Miss Invisible, they all got together. And they had to combine their powers to fight off this villain. The issue was, and I'm hoping 30 folk jump, that when they thought they can do it, they found out the missing piece was the fire. Now, some of y'all are saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, but you ain't got no fire. Because you have the Holy Ghost does not mean you possess fire. The old mother said, I thank God for being saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, and that with. She separated it. And that with, and listen to how they worded it, a mighty burning fire. Somebody shout fire. See, I can tell some of you ain't on fire, you just got heat. You know, when a pilot from the old stove back in the 70s and 80s, 50s, 60s, when the pilot goes out, you can turn the knobs all you want to. You can even light a match. Nothing will happen on the stove. These young girls don't cook, so they don't know nothing about what I'm talking about. They cook everything in the air fryer. But real food need fire. Real food don't want all of those little energy things that cause cancer going through your body. You need to burn the cancer in the meat by applying. They would tell us, light the pilot. Now, when you had to light the pilot, for 10 of you who were at your age, you got a long piece of newspaper or a brown garbage bag. I wish I had, And you lit it and you approached it with caution. Because, I'm going to see you scream, the same thing you want to light could blow up in your face. That's what happened to some of you who were trying to be nice to other people. Instead of them catching on fire, you helping them blew up in your face. That's why we approached it like this. Once the little pilot got lit, you can see a whole line of fire. Sometimes you could hear it. It'll just cut on like a burner. And that's what happened on Pentecost. It came in like a rushing. Some of you ain't gonna scream, but your role has lost its fire, but you're the pilot. And God says, as soon as you catch on fire, it'll go down your whole road. Now I'm going to give you a warning. After tonight, stop hanging with folk who say they save, but they are boring, non-engaging, not a worshiper, loud everywhere but in the house of God. One more example, then I got to read Judges, and then I'm going to fly my kite. When a person catches on fire, back in my days, they had a rule. In case the fire caught you, they said, stop, drop, and roll. Now, some of you ain't going to scream, but 50 of you should. Back in the day, you couldn't get saved unless you was a holy roller. Y'all remember that? You had to fall out. They had to catch you. They put covers on you. Stop, drop. You can't be still and handle the fire. The same fire that will bless you will consume you. Now this morning, Dr. Mixon so prolifically said to us that the Holy Ghost came in the form of a comforter, and she so sweetly said, a comforter is a covering. Then she went and said it was a quilt. And when you have and you're on fire, if you don't want to get killed, you stop, drop, somebody puts a cover on you. And they tell you, keep rolling. Somebody may not catch this, but 10 of you catch it for yourself. God said, only those on fire will I cover. You sit there all you want to, but you gotta act like I'm in a situation that's trying to consume me. I'm about to get a first degree burn from a demon. Lord, I'm gonna stop, drop. On that note, the book of Judges, my last scripture, then let's fly our kite. If you have the Holy Ghost and you publicly show that you're happy to have it, God said, I'll cover you for the rest of the year, for the rest of next year. I'll cover your children. I'll cover your children's children. But you've got to catch on fire. I don't believe in all that screaming. When you stop believing in it, it ain't that you ain't never believed in it. Your grandmama did it. Your parents did it. Where did you go that made you question the authentic experience of Pentecost? Wasn't no preaching in that upper room. Wasn't no singing up there. They were waiting on the power of the Holy Ghost. Look at somebody and be braggadocious, but be kind to them and tell them you're sitting or standing next to power. Tell them I'm full of power. I just don't know how to use it yet. I don't know to what ability I have. I need somebody not jealous of my power. 12 minutes,
I'm gonna holler.
They gave me 23 and I'll take it. Judges 15 verse 4 through 6. Samson went. Look at what it says. And Samson went and caught 300 foxes. I can't believe that my name Todd means sly fox. I found that out today. I should start using my middle name. Samson went and caught 300 foxes and took, y'all ain't with me, firebrands, and turned tail to tail and put the firebrand in the midst between the two tails of the foxes. When he had sent the brands on fire, they're missing it, he let them go into the standing corn of the Philistines, and they burnt up both the shocks, also the standing corn, and with their vineyards and olives. Then the Philistines said, who did all this? They answered, Samson, a son-in-law of the Timnite. And the reason why he did this is because you took away his wife and gave her to another man. Yep. I'm about to say this because y'all look lost. This is for verse 6 for 30 focal scream loud. Whatever you lost, you're about to get it all back. I promise you. God says, I'm going to make your fire go get it. I'm going to let you. Fire has one sure behavior. It spreads. Jeremiah said at one time, I've got one verse left. Jeremiah said at one time, Lord, I am turning in my license. I'm done. Now, I'm using him because five of you that are anointed don't know. You already quit, but you were fired before you quit. You can never beat God at getting rid of you. And the reason why you don't feel the way you do is you've lost your fire or passion for what you do. Oh, yeah. Fire is passion. Oh, yeah. And once you lose your want to do for what you no longer want to do, he replaces you. Now you're walking around like a match instead of a torch. Let me get out of here. Tell somebody, I'm a torch. Tell them, I'm a torch, baby. But Jeremiah told God, I'm tired of prophesying and how you use me, because when you use me, people don't like me because you don't let me say anything good like millionaire, money, houses. You make me tell them the hard stuff. They're no good. Get out of here. That's why I can't pack my church, y'all, because I just tell them the truth about themselves. But let me come back around, right? And Jeremiah got tired of taking a hit for the team. He told God, I'm done. Well, Jeremiah later on gets locked up in jail. Y'all don't hear what I'm preaching. See, you all don't like teaching, but Dr. Mixon, they called him the lamenting prophet. Lament, they called him the weeping prophet. He's prophesying, ministering under duress. He's crying after a good service. Y'all know? The real reason why he's crying is when he told God that he no longer wanted to be used or lost his passion for what God called him to do. This is the only one screamer. God told him, that's fine. Now you can know, he said, now you can never get married, nor will you have children. See, you didn't read that. When you quit on God, he'll show you something on the back end. He'll stop your productivity. He'll let you live to see what you could have been that you will never be. But while he was in prison, nursing his wounds and his emotions,
This is where the scripture was birthed for 34 cool jumping screen. He said, even though you have no need of me and I'll never get married and I'll never have kids, I'm not asking you to change your mind. He said, but I just need to get back in because thy word is like fire. See, some of you ain't doing it till you're willing to do it for free. Making a deal with God based on marriage and money and millions. Just tell him, thank you for waking me up this morning. And I wish I had 5 years. Clothing me in my right mind. Should have lost my mind by now. Activities of my limbs and the blood is flowing. Even though I have challenges, you have given me a fair portion of my health. And for this, I feel glory. I do now. For this, I give you praise. Look at somebody and tell them, you'll be okay. I'm the pilot. Tell them, don't stand too far from me. Get as close to me as possible. The Philistines came up. This is the B clause of that verse. And said, we gonna burn her and her father with fire. Samson's supposed wife told the secret to his riddle. She did that to avoid being burned with fire because the Philistines told her, if you don't help us, we're going to burn you, your daddy, and the house. On this note, I don't need 30. I need one real person. Even when she betrayed Samson, the outcome was still she got burned. You ain't going to get away treating nobody wrong. I don't care how you do it. And some of you ain't saying amen because you're behind on fire right now. I'm telling you. You don't get away even though you dress it up. You weave it up. You wrap it up. So let me encourage the few of you that have been betrayed. The verdict for them will be the same. The difference between the one that did you wrong and you who were done wrong, and if you don't jump on this, I'm going to just drop the mic, is the same fire that built you killed them. See the issue? Some folk jealous because they can't get in your space because that's going to separate the both of you. Why are you burnt and I'm built? I'm going to church now. Why are some of us being built while you're being burned? My hope is built. Let me hear my B because I feel God coming. Yeah, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood. I thought I had a fire starter. And his righteousness, I dare not trust the sweetest friend. Come on, y'all. But wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other grounds are sinking sand. Why is it? Then let me give my topic and fly my kite. Why is it that all of us are in the same experience tonight? Some of you look burnt and others look built. You look like first, second, and third degrees, and I look like I'm going to a new dimension. Why? How are we in the same service, in the same section? I'm being blessed and you look disconnected. What is the difference? When you put fire to plastic, the plastic shrinks. Y'all don't want me to preach. Then it dissipates and it leaves a foul odor. When you put that same fire to a log in a chimney, different smell, different assignment. And some of y'all ain't screaming for yourself, but God lets the same thing happen to both people to see who shrivels up. And who takes the fire and changes the temperature of the whole house. Some of you are going to be the reason why your neighbor who ain't moved got healed from cancer, didn't die in a car accident tonight, because they're sitting there with third degree burns. They're still nursing the pains of 1999. But when I think, let me hear my B again. When I think of the goodness of Jesus. Now, as I'm closing, you read about the two animals that were of the same species. It was two foxes. 300 of them in groups of two. It's getting quiet now. And they were tied together strategically by Samson by the tail. And then there was something put in between the tails that Samson could light that would make them catch on fire. I want to say this first, and this sounds incriminating, but this is my topic. And to the first 50 to jump and scream, you'll be blessed by tomorrow. And that is, my tail is on fire. Will you just tell somebody? I didn't say you're hot in the pants. That's the difference in yours and mine. I'm on fire, you in heat. He took these two tards, because tard means fox. He took tard. And he said, Tard, the only way you can stay on fire is you got to find someone like you. And I'm not going to let y'all lead each other because there's only one head, but I'm going to join you by the tail. Oh, yeah. And then how can two walk together? Y'all don't want. So I can't set one of you on fire and leave the other one out. See, some of you can't get blessed because you're too busy trying to burn the heads. That went way over some of your heads. Leave God's chosen alone. This is what he said about some of you that are the tail who will scream and jump and be dead free. He said, I'll make the tail the head. Some of y'all too worried about the heads. Baby, worried about God setting your tail on fire. As I prepare to close, the only thing that's stopping some of you from getting all that God has for you is who you are connected with. Stop letting best friends leave you in the worst situations. And find somebody that when you're praising, they ain't laughing, they're cheering you on. Because they know you've been through the floods and you've been through the fires and you've been through the flame. See, only the Hebrew boys could testify what I'm going to say for 10 folk who not have church, and that is, you can't burn when you're already burning. Y'all didn't see the actual flames on Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, better known as Azariah, Hananiah, and Mishael. But when they went in there, I think that King Nebuchadnezzar did the math wrong. He wanted us to count on what he did first. He said, did not I? Where's my talk, church? Did not I put three men in bound? But he said, I'm intelligent. I see four loosed. Let me do the math again. I put three in bound. And once I closed the door and let the fire have them, instead of getting burnt, they got blessed. Grab somebody, looked at them, and tell them, you're going to be blessed because you're connected to me. Deliverance is in who you're connected to. Well, there's two or three gathered together. Now, you that ain't moving, I hope your bills are paid. I hope you got your own house. I hope you ain't sick, because maybe you brought it upon yourself trying to be cute in an ugly situation. But well, there's two or three gathered together in my name, touching and agreeing. That's when God said, I will be in the midst of you. Y'all didn't do the math. Your name, Nebuchadnezzar. What Nebuchadnezzar forgot is the reason why there was another person in there, is there was two and three gathered in his name. Any place where there's more than two people serving the true and living God, God will step in the midst of what you're going through. Look around your sanctuary and find two or three people that look like they on fire, and tell them God is on his way into our situation. But I'm not going to wait until the battle, I'm almost there, is over. But I'm going to shout right now. Lean on somebody next to you and tell them, catch on fire. Oh, Lord. Wow, the three boys were in the furnace. The fire had to respect them. The fire said, we normally kill anything that gets in the midst of us, but these three are covered by God. You ought to tell two or three people, I'm covered by the law. Yes, Lord. And if anybody refuses to talk to you, I'm almost there, let them know you gonna burn, baby, burn by yourself. Wow, the three boys were in the furnace. Wish I had a church. The Bible says that none of them was done harm. But now Nebuchadnezzar made a mistake. He made Jesus the fourth one. When Jesus ain't never a number, he's always the first. The reason why the fire did not burn them is because before they got in there, the Lord stepped into the situation. Lord. And the Lord began to talk to the fire. Sometimes
times when the Lord's not talking to you. He's talking to your situation. He's telling the sickness, you can have them just for a little while. Ah, Lord, cut my house up and cut the gain and let me preach. But if they ever testify, your testimony should be like Shadrach. Your testimony should be like Meshach. Your testimony should be like Abednego. Somebody asked me, what was their testimony? I'm so glad that you asked me. The testimony was, even if our God does not deliver us, he's still able. You need to grab somebody and tell them with power, the Lord is still able. Now I want to hear who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we could ask or think. Shake a neighbor's hand. Thank you for telling them. Shake a neighbor's hand and look them in the face and say, Neighbor, congratulations on surviving the worst season of your life. Tell your neighbor, where there's fire, there is smoke. And tell him, I'm telling the devil right in his face tonight, you don't want this smoke. The devil thought he had you. The devil thought he had you. The devil thought he had you. But grab somebody and say, neighbor, you've got two options. Either be burnt or be blessed. And tell them one thing about fire. It tries you. It proves who you are. But you gotta have a testimony like Brother Joe. He said, when he has tried me, when he has tried me, I'm win. He has tried me. Y'all preach. I shall come forth as pure gold. Gold tried in the fire. Gold tried in the fire. Silver refined by the fire. Y'all better touch three people now and tell them, are you the fox that I've been looking for? Tell me, I don't need you to leave me. I need you to catch on fire. And once we catch on fire, let's go back and get what's ours. The devil stole it, but I want it all back. You ought to tell somebody, I want it all back. God has been too good to me. I wish I had a sanctified church that would shake a neighbor's hand and tell him, catch on fire. Y'all ain't Pentecostal, but I promise you that after midnight tonight, the fire is gonna bring it back home. Lord, give me my joy back. Lord, give me my peace back. Lord, give me my mind back. Say it. Yeah, Lord. Just tell me so, so I can find another fox. But say, neighbor, when I was a child, sometimes a friend of mine would play a trick on me. I turned 5 years old. They put 5 candles on a cake. Told me, make a wish. Blow out the candle. I gave it all the breath I had. The candle went out, but the fire came back. Y'all remember that candle? And the devil thought that last year he blew you out. But in 2024, the fire is about to come back. Yeah! Yeah, Lord! Yeah! Don't you insult nobody. If you got bad breath, don't breathe in their face. But say, neighbor, I'ma play the devil's advocate. I'ma blow in your direction. When I blow at you, either you stay the way you are, or let me see your comeback. Blow in your neighbor's direction. See if they let you just blow. Let them know you don't breathe on me, cause I already been breathed on. The Bible said that he breathed on them, and he said, receive ye the Holy Ghost. Breathe on someone and say, receive ye the Holy Ghost. Tell somebody, receive ye. Fire back yet? You still letting the devil blow on you? Make him regret that he ever blew in your direction. Anybody with the Holy Ghost, clap your hands and say yeah. Trying to see who got fire. About 200 of you, as loud and long as you can, just say fire! Look at somebody and mean it and say, neighbor, we may not have the same testimony, but I want to let you in on something. Within the past few years, you're looking at a person that should have died, lost their mind, backslid, or just did anything. But tell them the reason why I survived is something on the inside. Are y'all testifying? Something on the inside kept on working on the outside. You ought to tell your neighbor it was the Holy Ghost. Say that Holy Ghost till you get familiar with it. It was the Holy Ghost. Sometimes you just gotta cry, holy. Somebody just come on, shout holy. Come on, Shabak and guess, shout holy.
Hold someone's hand a minute. Hold someone's hand a minute. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, Lord. If you put fire in water, it will fizz out. I'm gonna see who yells real loud now. But if you already got oil and you light oil, it burns for a long time. And some of y'all got watered down salvation, but some of us, we got oil. And when you strike oil and strike a match, you've got an explosion. Y'all, God is about to explode some of you. Take your places you would have never gone. God said, I couldn't take you while you were watered down. You lost too much of your passion to represent me. You're doing it just to do it. It's like muscle memory. He said, but I need a new clientele, those who will go out there boldly and tell the world, look what God has done for me. Can you testify that to someone, that the Lord has been good to you? The Lord has done great things for me. Whereof I am glad. I'm on fire. And I know I'm not on fire by myself. And 30 of you scream on this. If anyone near you is praising God, you tied to the right person tonight. And they're gonna help you get everything you lost back. All it took was for you to find someone who would agree. Not be angry, would agree. I'm not jealous if you build a house first. Not jealous if you get married first. I'm on your tail. Oh, y'all didn't catch what I said. Don't care who go first. Just let the other one know, get yours, but I'm on your tail. You can't hide from me, because where there's fire, I want them Mahashianda Baho. I want you Mahoshia Tabahai. Somebody shout glory. I am Mashiach. Glory, hallelujah. I want to close with this and send y'all home to enjoy yourselves. Look at me. Samson, look at me, was promised, Crystal, a particular wife. When Samson came to claim what was his, the father said, I gave what I have for you away. I think it's better that you have her sister. Samson, and if you scream on this, you're serious, refuse to settle for less. Touch somebody and tell them, I refuse to settle for less. The only way not to get less was to come up with a plan. That plan was how to make the enemies regret that they ever came into your space. The plot was two foxes tied by the tail. Set on my shundai. Set on fire. Now, some of you act like you know the Bible because I see your face. I wish I could talk to you in private one day and we just go scriptures and talk about your sermons so we can see whether those sermons have been legitimized by proper contextual links, right? But let me say this for three of my members who will scream. Number one, if the two foxes were not in agreement, they would have ripped each other apart by running in opposite. They said the only way we're going to work this and not kill each other is we have to run together in the same direction. Last thing I want to say, because y'all don't look happy, especially on this side, y'all look too serious for me. But five of you in this section that's happy, catch this. It never said in the scriptures for screamers that the foxes died. The fire didn't kill them. It consumed everything around them. And I believe it stopped when the mission was complete. Nothing's gonna stop till you complete your assignment. And you got to get with people whose tails are on fire. And if they get there first, just let them know I'm still on your tail. That simply means I'm next. Pass that prophetic word across the whole sanctuary. I'm next. I'm going to learn what not to do by watching what you do. I'm next. I'd rather let a couple of mistakes go before me so that I can master what you messed up. You're holding the hand of a debt-free child of God. Lord, 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 Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Shakota Babaha. You got to find someone for the last time that's not on fire, pulling you in an opposite direction. You both will rip each other apart. So before you get tied to anybody, ask them, what's your calling? What's your mission? What's your purpose? What's your credit score? Where you live? How many children you have? Y'all don't like the interview? Have been married before? Because if you got a fire to live right and they have a passion to live wrong, they're going to rip you apart. The road has been rough. You're holding the hand of a debt-free child of God, and the going has been tough. And the hills
They've been hard to climb. But I've started out a long time ago. That's the truth. There is no doubt. Y'all talking like you know something in my mind. That I've decided, you finish it, to make Jesus my choice. He paid a debt he did not owe. And now we owe a debt that we cannot pay. You're holding the hand of a person whose score is going up 100 points. Their credit score. And it's going to happen because you touch and agree. God's going to set fire to that 400 credit score. And by the time you see it, it'll be at 800. God knows what to do. A lot of you in here are too spiritual. I don't praise them for things. I praise them for everything. Everything. So if you don't want your money, send it to us. Go and be saved and sanctified and broke. Enjoy it. But I want to be able to testify, look where he's brought me from. Now, I can look prophetically, I won't give you too much attention, and see that there's a group of jealous people. Because you never rejoice with others. You keep your eyes in one or two directions, and that's the directions of your cronies and flunkies. But some of us, we ain't stuck on no person. We need somebody who's on fire. I don't care if you don't invite me to dinner, I'm good. You ain't gotta pick me up and bring me to church. Next week I have my own car. And I'm gonna purchase it with fire. I said, I'm gonna purchase it with fire. What doth it profit a man? Look at this word, church, to gain the whole world. But if you seek ye first, come on, Shabbat, and his righteousness shall be what? Unto who? You're holding the hand of a fox. For some of you, that as close to a mink as you're going to get is that fox. Y'all just hold on to that fox. At least we graduated from rabbit. Y'all remember? I started off with rabbit, then raccoon, all kind of things. But you're holding the hand of a person who never told you how much they actually have been going through. And they're getting refueled because you just lit their pilot. They don't need you forever. They need you for this job right here. Just help me get my flame back. Help me find my passion. Help me find the joy that goes along with God's assignment. Help me find a love for people because that's God's commodity. He loves people. While we were yet sinners, he still loved us. You got to love somebody you don't like. You got to learn to love above life. You're holding the hand of a new homeowner. I'm prophesying. No money down, no money needed. God's got a miracle with your name on it. I
I told the people at the last church, as we prepare to exercise our rights, I told the people at the last church, sound travels. I want to talk to my church. There is no church on this Wednesday. We'll be in conference, so you already know that no one come here on Wednesday. But sound travels. I told you, learn that from physics and the fine applications. Are y'all listening? Catch this, just for half of you, out of 260-something of you, for those who won't talk. Catch this. If I prophesy to any of you and say, as I said to a few of you, that in 30 days, God's going to do this, that, and the other, you must apply a sound that will get to the 30 days. Hold on. Stop. This is where we are allowed to say, before it's done, it's already done. Because your sound went where your flesh cannot go. So your praise is already in tomorrow. But your sound must leave your voice today. Now, I did not. I did not prove this, Dr. Sanders, Johnny, over at the other church, but I'm going to say it to my church because I'm going to miss you on Bible study. Then I'm going to let you have 10 seconds to praise him with noise. But catch this. When it said, and hopefully Dr. Mixon will throw me a high five on this because we ain't going to dwell on it. When the day of Pentecost was fully come, there came a sound from heaven like a rushing mighty wind. And from that, the whole room was filled, and the Spirit of God indwelled in us. When you read Genesis, it says, God created the heaven and the earth, but the earth was without form and void. Darkness set upon the face of the deep. Then the Spirit, y'all gonna miss it. I knew you were gonna miss it. The Spirit hovered and moved over the waters. When the Spirit finished interviewing the situation, God said, hold on. In school we learned, and I only want 30 real yellers, that God never really spoke. The sound became words. When they said prophetically the walls would come down, somebody had to shout. That's why grandma used to say, for you who are not convinced, and I only need 2 millionaires to catch this, grandma used to say from the book of Exodus, when people heard thunder and lightning, shut up, God is talking. Because lightning is words that you can't hear, right? Because he moves as fast as sound travels. Some travels at the speed of light. So when he said, let there be light, that was sound traveling. At the speed to where darkness said, I can't handle this. And God said, your next sound would make what was trying to kill you get out your face. Because the issue is, this is the sound of Pentecost. Pentecost has a sound. You don't believe it, but one day you will. This is your final opportunity to touch somebody who you want to turn into a torch. Make that touch become a torch. Stop touching me without leaving me with some fire. I need your touch to make me a torch.
Uh-oh. You're not going to believe me. Don't get mad. God said, anybody that is still holding someone's hand, your deal is done. See, you didn't want to be tied to anybody. I don't need your money. I just need a light. Hold hands. If I can get my fire, I can get my own stuff back. May I have a light? I hear three of you being very pessimistic, being an antagonist. Because you can find flaws in any sermon because we're not perfect. But you're saying, why do we have to scream, jump, and holler? Why can't I be on fire without all of that? I get it. I'm not telling you can't. It's your business. But to those that I pastor, catch this scripture. Then I want y'all to scream again to make folk mad. And that's this. The Bible says, no man lights a fire and puts it under a bush. Because you that are on fire, you're like a city that's set upon a hill. God not trying to hide you. He's trying to expose you. And some of y'all got the nerve to still be holding hands. Ain't that special? You don't know what that means to the person whose hand you did not let go of. No one has ever held on to them that long in their life. Whee! Hey! We've been let go too easily, too long. I need somebody that's on fire to hold on to me even when I don't want to hold on. Now the power of the Holy Ghost is here. And we want this anointing, this power to go home with you. We want it to be in you. When you wake up, we want it to be lit. When you go to work, we want that fire to spread. When you go get a new job or need a vehicle, we want the price to be burned. All the way down to where God takes some of those zeros off. And it goes from $3,500 down payment to $30.50. We need God to step into the picture and not be the fourth one, be the first one. I did tell you, and I mean 2 minutes, that Nebuchadnezzar counted backwards. Because he could only count what he had his hands on. But when he opened it up, his eyes saw what his hands had nothing to do with.
And I'm going to prophesy now with no names, no social security numbers, no marriage. When I say this, those who scream, I mean it will happen right away. God says, I'm going to bless you to see me in something your hands ain't got nothing to do. That's the sound of Pentecost. I need God to give me something that my hands, Lord, my hands are not available because I'm too busy holding on to somebody else. Hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes. I'm glad y'all know church on things eternal. Hold to God's. Last time you're holding on to somebody that may not be holding on to you. D flat on the keys. Woo! Oh Lord. All right. Everybody. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper.
Everybody say,
a new
one. Everybody say, wait, promise keeper. With somebody, sing it from your soul. Oh, promise keep my God.
Heads bound. Thank you, God. Old school, I'm sorry, older saint. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Come on, louder. Then sings my soul, my Savior. Come on, mean it, mean it. How great thou art, how great. Way maker, miracle worker. If nobody sings with you, sing by yourself. Keep my God. One time, everybody, everybody. Then sing my. How great thou art. Heads bowed and eyes closed, no music. There is no secret what God can do. What is done for others, He'll do for you. With His arms wide open, He'll pardon you. There is no secret what God can do. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yanda, yanda, yanda. Yes, 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 Lord. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hiya! Hey, my house shown that about her. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, Lord. Oh, yeah, Lord. Shanda da da da. Shababa. I feel good. Have your way. Have your way. We going home. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. He ain't gonna do it if you don't ask him. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Come on, ladies. Have your way. Yeah, yeah. Have your way. Yeah. Your heads are bowed, your eyes are closed. We thank you for sharing with us on this Pentecost. Thank you for giving God the time that He deserves. Thank you for making this day holy. Thank you for asking God to light your fire. Thank you for not being ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because there's power, power, wonder-working power. I don't hear nobody in the blood. Those tumors are dissolved. Those growths are done. Hallelujah. I don't want... Go ahead and get it. Go ahead and get it. Go ahead and get it. I don't want to disturb you, but I won't lie. Y'all need to give me 2 minutes because I have not seen with my own eyes my people dance tonight. Did they dance? No, we dare not leave this building without signing our name on this ground. The devil wanted us to go home with noise but no dance. But for 100 of you that know that by tomorrow it ain't just a play date, it's a real date with destiny, and you know that God is about to turn your life around, I'm about to give you 2 minutes to pick them up and put them down. If they don't dance with you, don't worry about it. Those that dance with you, cut them a check when you get your new money. You've got 2 minutes to clap for them or dance with them. One, two, one, two, one, two, three, go! Go ahead, babies. Praise the Remus. 1 minute. Watch it, Bishop Sanders. Watch it, Ron. I don't care what y'all say. Young people, I feel my young people. Church all over the world. We got one more round. Help me. Leave, dance, leave, dance, leave, dance, leave, dance. Deacons, come on. Deacons, come get the baskets. Y'all gonna make me get a real dance, but we ain't doing it, I'm telling you. That's the grown-up section. That's sanctified section. That's the grown-up section over there. Listen, I was through, but let me say this. Some of you that need a miracle, this would be your first opportunity to do something you've never done. I'm gonna challenge at least 20 of you who've never danced. I don't care if it looks funny. Give it to God anyway. When you do, God said, I'm gonna drop something on you you ain't never seen in your life. So you've got 60 seconds to extend it and get that thing off you. One. Two, one, two, one, two, one, two, three. Get it off you. Get it off you. Get it off you. Some Elder Ferguson. Praise him, Manila.
music stops, you have a voice. You should have lost about 8 pounds. Don't gain it back overnight. Bow your heads. If you would help me do something without regret, I need 100 people split into two groups. I need 50 of us to give $30 and then the other 50 to give 70. Church, we are in a season where things are happening quick. I'm not playing fast and in a hurry. We don't save a lot of money in this church because we're always doing something new on this building. From new roofs to new air conditioned units. Now they're building new rooms for podcasts. They're bringing in new people, laying new concrete in the parking lot. And we don't have any type of campaigns for any of this. We just base it on the offerings, the tithe, and your love gifts. Amen. I've never said this before, but all of you, it won't happen tonight. If you're looking for a good church, you need to consider this church to be your home. I'm not one to go after people and members. This is the first night my church has ever heard me say this from my mouth. I think that this is a good place for your soul to land. And if you can make it through some of the rebuke and correction, you're going to look over your life and say, I'm glad that I joined somewhere where my soul matters. Amen. I am not Oprah Winfrey. I'm Dr. Phil. Let me say it again. I'm not Oprah Winfrey. I'm Dr. Phil. I'm not Mari Povich. I'm not Steve Wilco. I don't have a lot of followers because I'm a no-nonsense type of leader. And I believe right is what God is calling for in these last days. He demands it from me. Y'all ain't talking to me. And he demands it from you. We're not perfect. Can y'all finish that? But every day we wake up striving to be better. I just want to be a better version of myself tomorrow. I'm trying to become Prophet Hall 2.0. Amen. I'm going to, normally I would ask the least giver to give, but those who are going to sow 70, come. But let me put some oil on my hand, not in it. I won't anoint your heads, but I want to be able to shake your hand and get in covenant with you because I want God to increase your finances by 1,000. I know that sounds like a fantasy, but I want God to do it. Don't care who you are. If you're giving your 70, I want to shake your hands. You don't have to give. You're not going to hell for not giving. I don't preach that over here. Thank you so much. Oh, I've been blessed. I'm going to go get me some good food tonight. Hallelujah. If you don't want me to shake your hand, don't reach for mine, and I won't be offended. Just need y'all to do what is right. Amen. God bless you, Bishop. I love you so much. You don't know how much I love y'all. Amen. Amen. Tracy, what time you going in? 11:30 in the morning? We gonna have a new baby by 12 midnight. I love you. If you don't want me to shake your hand, don't reach for mine. I will not be offended. Hold to his hand. You can ask them and they'll give you change. Oh, hold to his hand. Build your hope on things eternal. Oh, oh.
Those who are giving you 30, come, I'm doing the same. Hold on. Those who are sowing your 30, come get it. You that are watching by social media, I pray that you would find it in your heart to sow into this ministry and into the kingdom. I hold to God's unchanging hand. Y'all give a change. Come on, please. Bill, I hold to God. I like you singing, boy. Love you. God's unchanging. God's unchanged. Bill. Hallelujah. If you had no money, but you need God to increase your finances, come shake my hand. See, that's anybody now. You, Bill? Come on, come on. Let us hold. Whatever you're giving, even if you can't give nothing, my hand in the place of God's blessings is available. Let us hold. Oh, God, you better build. Hey, y'all. Turn, oh, yes, oh, oh. His unchanging hand, his unchanging hand, his unchanging hand.
I love you.
His unchanging hand, his unchanging hand. His unchanging hand. You a bad boy. Unchanging hand. Unchanging hand. Build your hopes. Build your hopes on things eternal. I am not refusing anyone, even if you don't have money. This church wants God to give you an increase. I want you to live in increase. I don't care how drained I get doing this. I want you to live in abundance. Woo! Woo! Bless you, Apostle. Unchanging hand. His unchanging hand. His unchanging hand.
God's unchanging hand. Unchanging hand. Unchanging hand. Build your hopes. Build your hopes. Build your hopes. Build your hopes. Everyone's build your hopes on things. Build your hopes on things. Oh, 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 oh to God.
Everyone standing, we're going home. This was a day to remember. I want to say between now and August, if I can get an applause, I'm going to do something because I see it's necessary. Once a month until God says different, we're going to have a Sunday night service once a month. Are y'all clapping for that? It will be prophetic in its intention, but the prophetic will be ignited through good worship. So we're going to go straight from worship to thus saith the Lord, and I'm going to ask my committee and those who pray with me for us to choose what Sunday in the month that we're going to start this. Might start off small, but I believe that God's about to do something great in these last and evil days. I'll be utilizing the choir and the praise team every now and then, a guest choir, because I think the city needs a wake-up call. And why not start here in South Apopka at the place of passion? I don't hear nobody. It's going to be great. I'm asking all of you, then I'm going to let executive pastor come send us home. I'm asking all of you to pray for all of us that are going to North Carolina. I can't hear no applause for that. It's our mid-year leadership meeting, and we're taking about 20 of us are going to Jacksonville. We leave on Wednesday, some leave on Tuesday. We'll be back on Saturday. We'll be having Sunday morning service here. But I want you to pray for us. I also want to ask my members to follow me live sometime tomorrow, where I can persuade you and you obey your leader to register, because you need those classes online. It is not good to be a part of a ministry and let us outgrow you, and then you think this ain't the church when you stop being a part of the growth. All right? So if you can't go and pay what we're paying, you can at least pay registration and stay connected by way of virtual, right? Amen? So please tune in, follow me tomorrow, press notification, what have you, and I'm going to tell you why this week means something to us all. They're coming from everywhere, and we're going to be there. Our host church, hopefully you will clap, is now called the Family Worship Center of Shabak. Oh, that's Bishop Keith K. Curry and later Keisha Curry, co-pastor, are hosting it. And then we're getting ready, not many months from now, for Holy Convocation 2024. Can y'all scream for that? It will be held here in the city of Orlando, Florida. We had a great time last year. It seemed like time is flying, because it seemed like we just got out of Holy Convocation. And we're coming back around. We want you to be a part of it. I'll start making myself a little more accessible, pushing our ministry a little more. But I had to wait till it grew to a certain place, because I don't believe in growing weeds. Amen? Amen. Weeds don't need seed. They just pop up anywhere. Amen. They go when they want to go, come when they want to come. But when you're planted, you don't get to pick and choose and move around like that. So we thank God. I love you all. Oh, shucks. I love you all. Yeah, practice loving on each other. I said, I love y'all a bunch. Amen. I love you with my heart. Pray for me as I go on my weight journey. I'm back in the gym. I'm trying to get my sexy back. It's going to take some time. But I'm working on the building. It's a sure foundation. And my workout partner's here. Howie Wave. My workout partner's here. We work out together every day. And we're in there not playing around. We post a little bit. But after we get better at it and it makes sense, we'll give you better posts. Amen? Please, for the woman of God that's coming, who survived stage 4 cancer, who made it back into life, let us respect the office of Overseer Sonia Mixon as she comes.